So folks, the theme of what I want to talk about today is this out in the open sort of trend towards white supremacy with Donald Trump. We know it's always been there, but it's more out in the open right now. But before we get there, let me just throw out a few of these things that I see going on right now. So first off, you've got this picture of Donald Trump on Fox News, Trump donating $1,300 for hurricane relief. He's out there holding up one of these checks. It's like 2 feet wide by a foot. $1,300. Every little bit helps, billionaire. Thank you so much. And then you've got Elon Musk out there, folks. He said this morning, we got to win. But once we do, we can cut the millions of strings that, like Gulliver, hold back the giant that is America. Well, hold it, Elon. Don't forget that Donald Trump was in office and he already had 4 years to do this. And what did he do? But he rolled back, according to the New York Times here, the bulk of the rollbacks identified by the Times were carried out by the EPA, which weakened Obama-era limits on the planet-warming carbon dioxide emissions from power plants and from cars and trucks. He removed protections from more than half the nation's wetlands and withdrew the legal justification for restricting mercury emissions from power plants. That's the reality of what he did. Okay? Not making it up. That's the truth. That's the record. So I get so tired of hearing Elon say, we're going to do this, we're going to do that. Well, he had 4 years. And guess what? You know, this is what he did. He rolled back environmental protections. And then folks were finding out that guess what? Everybody got stranded at that Coachella rally because Donald Trump didn't pay the bill. And here's the proof. Team Trump ignored the bus's repeated request for payment. The company didn't get paid, so they didn't pick the people up. Everybody got stranded. And then, folks, you've got this whole trend. Let's talk about this of Nazism, white supremacy out in the open. This boat rally down in Florida, of course, with everybody with Trump placards out there like they love to do. But now we got boats with Trump placards and swastikas. So it's this whole trend toward white supremacy and Nazism that's troubling. And as another little indication of proof here, folks, we've got this article that's coming to us from the Daily Beast that says white supremacist slogan spotted at Trump Vance rally just out today. It says the Trump camp is facing backlash for what critics say are increasingly fascist overtones at the Republican candidates' events. Examining footage from a Trump rally in Saginaw, Michigan on October 4th, USA Today reports that almost a dozen GOP supporters were seen holding up placards emblazoned with the slogan Reclaim America, which we all know is well known in certain circles for its associations with the Patriot Front, the article says, a Texan neo-Nazi organization currently facing at least two high-profile lawsuits for attacks on black citizens. Fast forward to today, folks, we've got this picture of Donald Trump that he sent out today that shows him with his arm stretched out, pointing at New York City, saying, President Trump is coming to Madison Square Garden in New York City. And I didn't think that much about it until I remembered what James Carville said, that Trump's volatile language is reminiscent of rhetoric used during the Third Reich, as he urged the Harris campaign to switch up its attacks from Trump being weird to downright scary. And we're getting to that point, folks, where it's getting downright scary. James Carville said this. I did not realize that when I said that he would actually go on television and say, I'm going to use the military to round up my political enemies, Carville said. When I said that, I didn't know that he was going to schedule a rally at Madison Square Garden to mimic the Nazi rally of February 20th of 1939. So what happened on that day in Madison Square Gardens? There's an article by NPR. It's entitled When Nazis Took Manhattan, February 20th of 2019 is when it came out. And it says, on the evening of February 20th of 1939, the marquee of New York's Madison Square Garden was lit up with the evening's main event, a pro-American rally. The organizers had chosen the date in celebration of George Washington's birthday and had procured a 30-foot-tall banner of America's first president for the stage. More than 20,000 men and women streamed inside and took their seats. The view they had was stunning. Washington was hung between American flags and swastikas. The rally was sponsored by the German-American Bund, an organization with headquarters in Manhattan and thousands of members across the United States. In the 1930s, the The Bund was one of several organizations in the United States that were openly supportive of Adolf Hitler and the rise to fascism in Europe. They had parades, bookstores, and summer camps for youth. Their vision for America was a cocktail of white supremacy, fascist ideology, and American patriotism. At Madison Square Garden, the rally opened with the Pledge of Allegiance to the American flag. The mood was jubilant. Attendees wore Nazi armbands, waved American flags, and held aloft posters with slogans like "Stop Jewish Domination of Christian America." There were stormtroopers in the aisles. Their uniforms were almost identical to those of Nazi Germany. It looked like any political rally, only with a Nazi twist, said Arnie Bernstein, author of Swastika Nation. The speeches were explicitly anti-Semitic, and tirades against job-taking Jewish refugees were met with thunderous applause. Back in the day, it was job-taking Jewish refugees. Today, it's Donald Trump talking about immigrants taking black jobs, which he says over and over and over again. Folks, we've got to see what's going on here. We're moving in that direction. This is Donald Trump's dream for America. And it's so closely aligned with what happened on that day back in February 20th of 1939. We have to see the connection between the two. We can't lose the connection of what he's going to do and what happened in that same arena back in 1939, folks. There's a lot more going on in this election, I think, than we even realize sometimes. There's so much at stake. And it's this trend towards white supremacy and the immigrants taking your jobs and all of this other rhetoric, right? The enemy, folks. And there's so many parallels to what happened back then. And there's so many parallels towards this move to authoritarianism that should concern every American that can vote out there. Something we have to watch. And I want to see who's going to be at that rally, folks. Which of the white supremacists, which of the American Nazis are going to be there? Scary stuff. Till next time.